杰拉农科学奖，什么化学奥林匹亚冠军，有 SAT ACT 成绩就不用说了。他还是冰上花滑的一个就是 professional 的一个选手吧。说到康州 Bridge， 其实这里真的是一个也是一个总统奖还有科学奖华裔学生比较聚集的一个地方。因为去年其实我们采访的一名华裔男生，他就是2017年总统奖得主，而且进入到了斯坦福大学。那今天我们要采访的这Michelle吴呢，他是已经进入普林斯顿大学，今年已经是大一的学生了。所以今天我们去其实是趁着他休假的日子，真的是很不容易才约到的。他在普林斯顿的日子，据他所说是非常繁忙，从早上8点钟到晚上10点钟，我当时跟他约1个小时都约不来。
欢迎，
刚才我们已经拍了一些了，就是他的一些介绍，他之前的一些获奖的证书啊，还有什么的。
嗯，很好。
对对，您今天是在家吗？等会我们可不可以也采访您一下，就是介绍一下是怎么把女儿培养这么优秀的？
啊，可以不？可以分享，
可以分享
啊！
太好了，太好了。So you are saying like when you are first going to the coding class, you are the only girl there?
So it was just me and maybe.One or two others occasionally.
How many boys are in there?
Maybe like over 10.
So actually the percentage of boys is much higher than girls.
Yeah.
And they have a better basic knowledge about that also.
Yeah, so the programming club was mostly filled with people who already knew how to code, had a lot of experience with it, and were just kind of there to hang out after school.
Your initiative is to teach girls who don't know anything about coding.
Right. So it was definitely difficult at the beginning because we ourselves didn't have that much programming knowledge. I had done a little bit, and I had some basic JavaScript knowledge, but for the most part, I was relatively new to programming as well. So it was definitely difficult balancing, you know, trying to learn the coding ourselves and then also making plans for the day-to-day club meetings.So this is our Under My Wing website, and this is the homepage. So we see Under My Wing, and then a little bit about how we got started, some screenshots from our app, explanations of the different components of the app. So we have emergency call buttons, a self-defense feature where we have self-defense video tutorials, so you can learn how to do certain self-defense moves.
So how many girls actually collaborate together to develop the app?
So we had about 9 kids. And then between the 9 people, we were split up in different roles. So there were a couple people doing coding and development, and then other people doing, you know, layout planning, images, color scheme, and stuff like that.
And why do you interested in teaching the young people about defending themselves in particular?
So I think at that point, there was a lot of stuff going on about Me Too. And the whole like sexual assault movement. So that's something that really piqued our like
attention.
So that's kind of what got us started. And the more we thought about what we really wanted to do, we wanted to give people tools to deal with a threatening situation. So
how do you think your family kind of influence you? Maybe like your parents, I know they are both from technology sectors.
I think my family was definitely very helpful because they were always very encouraging. And I always kind of had the mentality that I could do anything I wanted to, not really be bounded by any sort of stereotypes.
啊，刚才跟这个Michelle聊的时候，我就觉得她其实是一个特别 self-motivate， 就是她自己的动机，她自己的 motivation 很强的一个女孩子。
我想她从小吧就开始溜冰，然后我还记得她一开始参加她那个溜冰队嘛，第一季度去参加比赛，每个比赛都是最后一名，根本就没有拿到什么奖，这是第一年。然后，然后我就也有点担心啊，小孩会不会觉得就是怎么这么难，做的不好，会不会打退堂鼓？结果她就 stay on 了。然后第二年他们那队就做了很好，到第三年的时候他们就拿了全国冠军，所以然后他们一个 season 里面有好多次比赛，那真的我觉得非常 impressive。他可以去一次比赛，他拿了第一名，对不对？晚上都比到10点多钟，然后第二天一早6点，整个队又在冰场上 然后教练就跟他说，又要训练，对对对，就是在做下一，在准备做下一次的比赛，就是说 how to do it better， OK。
其实我特别想让他讲一个故事，就说感人的故事，或者是说他曾经想要放弃，结果在你们的鼓励之下又顽强的站起来，就是这种激励人心的故事。但是他好像就觉得这是 day to day 的一个东西，就是他很难讲出一个具体的事情来。
I don't know if I have any concrete stories. It's just kind of the environment I grew up in, and just like everything that happened as cumulative.
小孩主要是培养他们的兴趣，他们 they need a passion.For something， 所以我就让他们尽量去 explore different activity。他小时候踢过足球，打过网球，弹过钢琴，然后有小提琴，然后也吹过就是 flute， 就是给他们 experience different thing。可是最后我就要问他们，你到底喜欢什么？然后要选一样，然后那一样你就得坚持下去。
How did you become this way?
I mean, my parents always encouraged me to do well in school and.You know, like pursue things I'm interested in and just always pushed me to do stuff. So I think that's part of it growing up. But then, like, since I've developed that type of mindset, I just, you know, like to keep myself busy, like to do well, like to, you know, be high achieving, whatever.
就你们到时候是一般去普林斯顿，你们是接送吗？都是开车接送？
没有，他会自己坐火车去。如果，因为他如果有好多东西带的吧。好多东西带我会送他去，如果没有好多东西那就自己坐火车，很方便的，这里坐火车。
人家不是都说突然小孩就是考完大学走了以后家长会有一种失落感，
对，像过年一样了。然后他还跟我说不许再煮菜了，煮了太多菜了。
然后你这两天也专门请假在家陪他是吧？
对啊，然后可以跟他，因为他现在很少回来了嘛，所以就跟他在一起多 spend 一点时间在一起。
Currently planning on pursuing a computer science degree. At Princeton, we don't need to declare until the end of our freshman year. I'm not exactly sure what I want to do yet. I think I'm interested in software development or using technology and coding to address some sort of issues. So startups are pretty interesting to me because they're, you know, a small group of people who are really trying to address a certain issue. And I'm just going to take my time at Princeton to explore the different avenues for that.